doing, ladies and gentlemen? I'm John Robert Cruz, your host and producer for this program. Today I have the pleasure of interviewing a Major League Baseball player scout by the name of Hector Garcia, who has many years of experience as a baseball scout. How you doing, Mr. Garcia?
How are you? How are you, John? How's it going?
I'm doing fine, sir. Okay. You know, we've had some preliminary conversations about doing this interview, and let's just go for it, okay?
Sure.
There's a lot of people out there who love the game of baseball, who play the game of baseball, and there's a lot of people out there who still have that dream of becoming a big league baseball player.
Yes, sure are.
Right?
Billions.
Billions, right?
Yeah.
Didn't you tell me people are playing baseball in China now?
Yeah, they're starting in China actually now. A friend of mine played in China. He speaks Chinese, a young man, and he's played over there. He was walking through the park one day. He saw some guys throwing a ball, and he went out there. They invited him to play with their club team. So he stood over there. He made good friends. He stayed there for quite a while, and now he's back working in the city.
Are we talking mainland China?
Mainland China. They have college teams, and they're starting to play baseball in China, where they have a billion. So eventually they're going to come, and they're very good athletes, the Chinese.
Think about that.
Yeah.
I would say that's some Chinese food for thought. What do you think, folks?
It sure is.
Right? Well, listen, Hector, how did you start as a baseball scout?
Basically, when you're going to be a baseball scout, a lot of these jobs is who you know, because it's... and during my career, and as I grew up on Freeman Street in the Bronx, I met up with a good friend of mine, and we grew up together, Danny Monzon, who from Monroe High School, he played in the major leagues with Montreal. He was spent about 4 or 5 years in the majors. And he eventually became a scout for the Mets. And as I was retiring from my semi-pro baseball career, he needed somebody to help him out in the city. And he asked me to help him out. And I actually got two players, one who got a cup of coffee in the major leagues was Johnny Manziel, whose son now, Johnny Manziel Jr., was up with the Mets this year, but his father was one guy that I discovered for Danny. And then Hector Berrios, who's now a pitching coach for the Mets in the minor league system, I also helped get that guy. Okay. And then what happened was the scout from the Kansas City Royals was going to be made into a full-time guy. So they were looking for a part-time scout. And Danny recommended me for that job.
And what year was that?
And about 1986.
1986, great. Yeah. And so you got recommended, and then?
And after that, prior to that, I had been helping Danny as a bird dog with the Mets, because he was with the Mets at the time.
Wait a minute. You just said bird dog.
Yeah.
I don't know what that means. Please tell me.
Dog is a guy who works for the team, but he's not on salary.
Okay.
You're not getting paid by the team, but you love the game, and you go look for guys, and you say, hey, Danny, I got this kid. Come check him out. That's what you do without salary. And it's one way to get your foot in the door. By doing that, which is a lot of guys doing that now. So then I got picked up by the Royals, and I became the part-time scout for the Royals. I was with them for about 17, 18 years.
Okay, that's fantastic.
17, 18 years.
Well, let me ask you, we can go into, you know, different positions, this, that, and the other. Mm-hmm. But let's say, what do you look for starting off the bat in a hitter?
The first thing you look in a batter is the approach. You want to see how he approaches the plate. Is he coming up there with confidence? How he stands at the plate? You also look for they have to be fearless. Do they stand in the box and, like, you know, challenge the pitcher with no fear? Then, of course, you look to see what, you know, how they grip the bat. You don't want to see if their hands are locked up. You want to see that they have nice and loose hands. And then you're going to look for the bat speed. Look for bat speed, and do they take the bat to the ball? A lot of players are just zone swingers, which is they'll always swing in the same spot, and if the ball's down here, they'll still swing up here. And when they catch the ball, they're going to hit it 450 feet. So you want to see if the person is able to take the bat to the ball. If it's up here, you take the bat to the ball.
So in other words, if it's an inside pitch, they're going to swing accordingly down the pipe and outside?
If it's an inside pitch, are they able to get... open their hips early,
right?
If they're able to get around on a fastball, and And basically, is the bat speed. You want to see that bat speed.
Okay, all
that
right.
That bat speed. And if they can, they have bat speed and they can take the bat to the ball, then you can work with that. You can work with that.